What's up, YouTube? We back. It's Tay and Evan, and if this is your first time listening to us, we just want to welcome you to our channel. We try to.
If you like the video, like, comment, and subscribe. Today we got a story from you. You've probably already heard of it. The 56-year-old godfather dating a 18-year-old child.
Yeah, so I think I was I was doing something, and Ebony had kind of sent me this story. I never heard of it until she sent it to me. We kind of, when we do have time for each other, we just kind of chop it up and catch up on the week to see how everything going, and we just sitting here pretty much just talking about it, and I was looking into it. I was like, this is
disturbing.
Very, very strange.
It's very disturbing.
It's not something that you hear about every day.
And so, if you haven't heard about it, there is an 18-year-old girl named Deja, and she was running away from her mother and staying with Mike, and they were living together. The mother was on drugs and selling drugs, as she admitted in her own video.
Well, I guess before all that happened anyway, he was pretending to, like I said, when she ran away, he kind of pretended that he didn't know where she was.
Right.
And you see, like, he had made a little Facebook post and, asking people to help, time is of the essence, we got to find her. And pretty much the whole time,
she went
him. Like, it's crazy. And then, like, you knew this girl since she was a baby.
Yes, a baby.
A baby.
Like, they have pictures of him holding her on Facebook. That is so disturbing, because a lot of people don't see what's wrong with it. That's because they're baby pedo bears. But the people that do see something wrong with it, like, this is a 56-year-old man. This is a man that is double her age. And then some.
And then he lied about his age. He told her that he's 46.
Yeah.
But it's like, from the police records, it say he was born in 1966. I mean, y'all do the math.
I think she's just saying that to try to make it look a little bit better. But it don't.
But it don't.
It really don't. It looks terrible. It looks bad on everybody's end. But I didn't really understand it until the mama posted her video, because her mom and her daddy failed her. Her dad was absent, and her mom was just going off in the video. Like, she has lived that life, and you can tell that she was not really there for Deja. That she said it herself, she was in and out of prison, fighting, on drugs. Like, the saddest part of the video, she's like, I will mess you up, but I ain't got to do nothing physical to you. I send the spirits for you. Like, you want to fight and or put a hex on your own daughter? She's viewing her daughter as competition and not as a victim, which that's what she is. She's a victim. Her mind is blown. Because you done got with this older man who has money, who's probably good in bed.
Got money.
Maybe not. Well, she said, she got a big rock on her feet. I'm not even gonna lie about that, y'all. The rock.
He stays
the rock
with projects.
Is big.
He got money.
Well, I didn't know that.
Unless he trapping,
I mean,
people who be trapping do stay in the project, so. Because the way in the video, she's like, we got on half this stuff out here.
And she probably just sent his retirement fund and like, oh, we got it going on.
Right, because
he got a 401k.
That's probably like the most money she ever seen. Like,
yeah.
It is.
They probably just easily impressed.
Right. But, that's what older people do for younger people, because, like, it's easy to, wow them, because, like,
because they never been sexually intimate before. Wait. So this older person getting with you is blowing your mind, because you've never had any of this ever done to you.
That's like, even like when I was in middle school, you have like older cats that would They drove up to the school, you know, the little girl like, oh, you know, he got a car. They don't even care that it's his mama car, but you know, still, it's
they
just
don't
like,
know. They just naive. They like, oh, he with it, so is he. Like they don't critical think. They don't think like there's a possibility that it's not his. They just see, oh, he in it, it's his. Like that's what they think.
Right.
And they was doing the same thing from where I'm from. And it was disgusting. Like, you have all these older men, 20 and up, at a middle school, waiting for middle school girls.
They think they got their money. We got money, got a car.
But that is disgusting. Like,
So do you think the mother is like hurt about her daughter taking, well, not taking, but the daughter marrying the boyfriend, or do you think she just like whatever? You think she feels?
I feel like she is hurt because she's comparing her like as in competition. We did this, we did that, like. And then, like, telling her, saying your daughter was just over there crying to you, and you gonna mess her up. Like, it seems like she sees her as competition. But me personally, like, I would be more disgusted than trying to compete with my child. Like, my child mind is messed up right now. She's a victim.
You think it's gonna be one of those precious moments? You messing with my man. You remember all precious? You remember when Monique,
yeah.
Like she was mad because, you know,
yeah.
But you know, even though like she was a willing participant on this, but you know, Precious was raped.
Right.
But
she's been raped too. I just don't see this as possible. It is no way you just up and marry someone at the legal age of consent. And you didn't groom this girl starting early. It is no way possible that this man has not touched this girl, raped this girl, anything, and that she's a victim. But she don't know better because she's not old enough to even know anything about her body, anything about her mind. Girls develop fast, but they don't develop that fast to where they would just know, you know, that this man is manipulating me. She won't know until she's probably like 25, 30, and by then she's gonna be so mortified at the situation, so embarrassed, right.
and feels so stupid.
And then you got a video to go back and look
right.
at.
Right, you're gonna be like, God, yeah, I said all that. Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
For the world to see.
And then you're gonna be right back crying to your mama, mm-hmm. just like her mama said. You out here fighting these little girls because he's sleeping with other girls. Men, they have an appetite for young women. They don't have an appetite for one young woman. They have an appetite for all young women. He probably still up at the middle school looking for even younger women because he knows the one that he's with is aging.
Tell it, Ibby.
Like, you can't.
Tell it. That it is. Let them know. Let them know. They need to hear this. Y'all need to hear this. You got the flow.
I'm not going to play with you.
But that's really how they be, though. Like, they get the young girl because, like, you can pretty much get away with everything because, like, you could tell them anything. They'll be like, okay.
Thank you. Thank you, because they don't know anything about finance. They don't know anything about money. They don't know anything about sex. They don't even know who they are at that age. Girls at 18 years old do not know who they are. And he's taking advantage of the situation because she don't know what she stands for. You know, this is a young girl who had no discipline, no stability, no structure, right. No mama to tell you, oh, this is what you accept, this is what you don't accept, because she having sex for a phone
and $150
and $150 on a phone. Like, you having sex for all these menial things, so of course your daughter gonna look at you, oh, like she's struggling, oh, but he can buy me a phone, you know, he can buy me food, like he giving me a place to stay when I was out homeless and working, you know. She sees him as an asset, but she don't see that he's manipulating her mind, that he's ruining her life.
Yeah, he like messed her up bad. God.
Yeah, and he started a young one. Yeah, he did.
Oh, most definitely. I really feel like he should be in jail. Like,
he should.
I know for a fact he was messing with her before she was 18. Cause ain't no, you wake up like, oh, I feel like marrying my stepdaughter. Well, goddaughter, whatever you want to call her. Like,
right.
And ain't no way nobody's gonna wake up like, yeah, I'm gonna marry my goddaughter. No, you've been thinking about this for a while, probably since she was a little baby.
Yeah, and been doing it for a while because the mama said she was whooping her at 14 for running away. If you run away at 14 and you over his house, what is you doing over his house at 14?
Right. I wanted to, like, he have any friends that just be like, that's why you should have good friends. Even if you talk to your friends about it, your friends should be like, no, you don't need to be. You know, you don't need to be doing
well,
that.
He lives in the projects. Of course, all the men he's talking to is like, oh, dang, they he got a good one. Oh, you got that. You did that. Look at her. She bad. Like, nobody is going to be like.
She bad on a tricycle.
That's a child.
She on a tricycle and she bad.
Well, it's accepted in the black community, if we being real. Child molestation is accepted. Women protect their men instead of their children.
Yeah.
That's what happens. And people know what's going on, but nobody say nothing because it's going on everywhere. Because it's become normalized to the black community.
Yeah, but people give up their child just say they got a man in the house.
That's true. Mm. And let men do whatever they want to their kids. Tell their kids all kind of stuff. There's not enough love for kids in the black community. It's not. That's why R. Kelly was able to get away with what he got away with for all these years. Because people don't care, especially when it's a black female. When it's a black female, nobody cares.
R. Kelly also had money to turn to make people look the other way.
But it's a lot of people that's trafficking young girls, and a lot of people look the other way because the black female, period. People look the other way.
So
like, oh, there's none of my business right there.
No.
Like, I will make it some of my business.
Yeah, most definitely. So, did you see the video? Did you see her live stream when she's, I guess, going off on everyone about being in her business?
It's none of
our business, but, you know, it's just, this not something that you just see every day, yeah. I'm pretty sure he's not the first and he's not going to be the last person to do this.
No.
But, you know.
And he's not going to be the first or the last that doesn't get prosecuted for it.
All right. But I definitely believe he should be in jail. He definitely should be in jail.
I just hope one day that she sees that he's using her and that this is not normal. Like, and I understand you didn't have a father, so it's easy to get confused wanting a lover and a father at the same time.
Right.
It's so easy to get it confused. But I hope that she can look inside herself and see that you fighting other girls for this old man that's cheating on you.
And he gonna continue to cheat on you because he can tell you, yeah, baby, I ain't gonna do it again. What you gonna do? You gonna believe him?
Yeah, because that's a big problem. Like, women don't understand the game of black men when they don't have a black man as a father in the house. Like, they don't understand.
It's not just necessarily a black man. It's just a father, period.
I'm saying for us because this is a black man and a black woman. Okay. Or a black child. But she don't understand the games. She don't understand that he's making a complete fool out of her.
And see, when she realizes it's gonna be too late, it's gonna be like, how am I gonna get up out of this? You know, when she finally come do. Hopefully she don't be like too many kids in with you.
Right. Hopefully she don't get pregnant. Oh no.
But see, they say she do have a 2-year-old daughter, but you know, it's allegation that it may not be. You know, we're not sure. You know, we have to take that to Maury and find out. You know, because we don't know.
Right.
What you think? You think it's baby?
Oh no. I have no idea what you think. You think that's his baby?
I had to get the baby and hold it up to him and see what the baby looks like.
That is terrible, though. Like, you already have a baby before the age of 18. And now, of course, you're going to feel trapped. Like,
especially if you like taking care of the child, you gonna
and taking
she's
care
not
of
going.
her. She's
She's
not
not.
used to being taken
Yeah,
care
she's
of.
definitely not going nowhere. Like.
Not until she get older and see that this is not what's it. She's saying she don't want to be with older, I mean, with younger dudes because they can't do nothing for her, and because of a lot of them are gay, and which that is true, but there are good dudes out here.
Yeah, good young dudes.
Yeah,
her age.
That's doing stuff with theyself.
So what's the okay? So I'm speaking for you. What's the oldest you would go? Like if you're 18, what's the oldest you would go? Like what's the oldest? What's the minimum?
Well, I wasn't talking to nobody at 18.
Well, if you were to talk to
if
somebody
I
at 18,
were
what's
to.
Your what's the cap on the age?
20.
20.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what's the lowest? 18?
No, 19. Whatever age I am.
Yeah, I was like, of course it had to be 18. Anything else, you going to jail.
Yeah. Yeah.
So 18 to 20.
Yeah, 18 to 20.
I guess that's about right. I don't know. I think probably like three. I think about 3 years for me. I think about anything over three. I kind of feel a little funny about that.
Right.
You know?
As you should. That's what's normal. That's what normal people do. This is a pedo bear. Of course, he don't feel any type of way about it. It's a whole lot of older dudes that's dating younger girls, and they proud about it, even though they don't have nothing in common, nothing to talk about.
Like nothing at all, because y'all both got two different mindsets,
two different eras, two different decades. Like, no, two different generations of people.
Oh my God, I'm pretty sure it'd be stuff he'd be saying it, and
she like, "Who is that?
What is that?
Go put that on Davenport. What is that?
Davenport. Turn it on the heat of the night.
What?
you remember that show? In the heat,
yeah.
Of the night.
Remember with Gillespie? Yeah, I remember Gillespie.
The heat of the night. What
yeah,
what is that?
Matlock. Go turn it on Matlock.
Matlock.
We TV. Yeah. I'm just like, what man. Is that? What is any of that? Andy Griffin.
Oh, man, not Andy Griffin.
She's like,
whistling.
Huh?
He walking through the house whistling.
No. Like, there can't be a... I just find it hard to believe. I know a lot of girls, young girls, when I was in high school and middle school, that dated a lot of older dudes. And literally, none of them are together. They all come back and say how they ruined their life. Like, how they was living her life, fighting other girls for him, because he has a young appetite for young women. It's not that you're so special. It's that you're young. And as soon as he feel like, oh, you 20, you 25, oh, you getting old, let me go find another young one.
Because you getting to where you can see past my BS.
Exactly. You getting fed up.
Right.
I can't keep running game on you. Let me go find another young girl that I can introduce to sex and introduce to money and try to blow her mind just like I blew yours.
Just start over.
None of them are happy. I have a friend who was about 16 messing with a 35-year-old.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, yes. And he just took her for the biggest ride of her life. Took her for the biggest ride of her life. And she would stay with him for about 5 years on and off. And it was just horrible for her to try to get away from him. Because older men are really possessive. Like, they see you as an object. They don't see you as human. She was going through so much. And I couldn't feel bad for her because that's the life you chose. When you told us about you dating a 35-year-old, we was just like, nah.
Yeah.
It like, he's old enough to be your daddy. Like, that's weird.
I don't
wanna hit it. And then when he come around, he don't speak to us. He don't look at us. He just want to meet you at night.
Oh yeah, that red flag right there. That's because you know you.
Because he ain't trying to go to jail.
That's not even that.
He can't even take you on a date.
He probably got a main thing during the day.
And probably.
People be like that, like.
And she's
skipping
school to go be with him.
You know, one situation. You know, I knew a person like that. Like, you couldn't call them. You know, they had to always call you, but y'all so called in a relationship. You know, he only can meet up on certain days.
Right.
But you his main thing, and he feeding you, oh, we gonna do this, we gonna do that. You know what I'm saying? None of it never happened, but it keep you, you know,
satisfied for the moment.
Satisfied. Like, yeah,
because it's
like,
easy to satisfy a child.
You know, you going to tell your friend, oh, girl, he said he gonna do this when, you know, when we link up and we gonna do that, he gonna buy me this.
And he meets you every 2 weeks at night.
Like, what?
And bring your cheeseburger. Come on, baby, get in the car.
Eating up all that little cheese. He just sell you all kind of wolf tickets, and you just loving it.
Because they don't know better to discern. Women need to start teaching their children better. Teach them the game. So they don't fall prey to it.
But you think we should I think I'm gonna throw the videos in there for people who never seen the videos, but they say a lot of things, you know, they don't hold back nothing. They throw a lot of punches in them back and forth.
Not at all.
Especially mama. Mama put it all out there. I don't know what mama name is. They call her Peaches. Peaches is as good as it comes. But that's what they expect coming from Florida. They them all some good people.
That's out there. Right. That's Florida. They state good. Of the wretched.
No.
State of the wretched.
I don't know. Well, we in Ratchet City, so.
And we in Ratchet City, but we ain't never out nowhere near Florida.
Hey.
I'm sorry. Florida is a mess.
Oh, man. Yeah. But mama was just, she was good. She was just putting it all out there, all they been. And mama said she was out there snorting big coke, mountains of coke. You know what I'm saying? She was, you know what I'm saying? They couldn't keep none around for her. She came through that nostril getting it all.
Selling it at all.
Selling it. But you can't sell that snort. Like,
that's why she was in jail. She also been in jail.
Oh, man. But she really got me when she said, yeah, I let them smash for $150
and a phone.
Cell phone.
And I was working at Family Dollar.
Because Family Dollar wasn't paying me that much. So, gave it up.
Yeah, that's. She's teaching her daughter low standards.
Yeah, this.
So her daughter's like, oh, well, my mom went through the same thing. She was fighting other girls for him, right, so I'm going to do it too.
Right, mama was a good example. She was a good role model.
Terrible, just terrible example.
Mm-hmm. But even though, like, you know, the whole situation, like, I don't think mom, like, I understand mama upset, but you only get one mama. You know, I feel like mama should at least kind of, I know she said, I don't want to ever talk to you again. That was tough. You like, we done. I don't want to ever talk to you again. It's still your child at the end of the day. You still should try to reach out like, look, baby, you know. You need to open up your eyes. Like, you going down a path that you probably not going to be able to come back from if you go too far.
And that's true.
You know, instead of, nah, I don't want nothing to do with you. You know, you out here itching and, you know, like,
oh,
just
yeah.
bashing her, like, you know, you still should reach out a hand. Like, what would you do in that situation? Let's see what would you do. Your daughter out here messing with
a dude
you talked to for a long time.
I might initially feel some type of way, but then I'd be like, she's a child. He started with her young, and I brought him in her life. I'm the blame for this, really. Yeah. So, it is no way I'd be up on there trying to fight my daughter online.
Right.
Like, especially over a bomb that's preying on children.
So, would you still have a good relationship with your daughter?
I would try to.
So, okay. So, Christmas, she come around with him.
It's no, she's not coming around with him.
Yeah, Christian. They married. They married.
She can't come around with him.
They come around.
No.
And she, hey, mama. Hey, how you doing, baby?
No, she can't come around with him.
He come here and try to hug you.
No. And then she was saying how he was talking about how fat her meow was.
Oh, my.
When he coming to get stuff for her daughter.
Oh, yeah.
That's so disrespectful. That would make me so mad. Like, you really out here doing my daughter dirty. I feel like the parental instinct would be more aggressive than the I gotta compete with you. Like, that's retarded. Especially when it's a dude I was just having sex with.
Right.
It's not like
So he can't come to none of the family functions.
Oh no. Every time he sees us, he getting drunk. Everybody in the yard.
Everybody's stumping
up. Every able body in the yard. like they tell SpongeBob movie.
Oh man, not everybody stomping.
Every able body.
And then, you know, all y'all like to wear wigs. Oh my goodness, that's gonna be terrible. Yeah.
Every able body must participate.
Oh man,
it's law.
Even little baby can't walk. Just
put your cowboy boots on. Go get him. I'm sure. Show you something.
Oh man,
gotta get his mind right.
By then, she probably just gonna be like, well. You know, I can't bring them around. I just stop fooling with the family.
That's where they make their big mistake.
That's where they make their mistake in. Because you cut off your family that been there with you your whole life for this person that's going to be here temporarily.
Right. And when he isolates you, he got you. He's going to start beating on you. And everything is just going to go down. You ain't got nobody to talk to, nobody to run to. It's just you and your child. And he's going to use that child as leverage against you. All right. Like, I adopt the child. I do this. I do that. I claim the child on my tax and income tax. I'm the one with a job. Like, they just going to start manipulating you. And it's going to go further and further and escalate and escalate.
Get as much as you can about you.
All right? Until you take your soul. You're going to feel like he's taking your soul. Because everything around you belongs to him. He threatening taking your child. He abusing you. He all you know. He all you got. Because you done cut everybody off. And it's just gonna be you and him. It was by choice, but now it's by force.
All right. And then so.
Well, what you thought was choice.
Because so I'd be. Because
she defended him.
Once you finally realize what's going on, and you're like, I gotta get away. Where you gonna get away to?
You don't know nobody.
Yeah. You cut all ties with people. People don't wanna deal with you. They're like, nah, we don't, you know. You cut us off a long time ago. Nah.
Right now, 5 years later, and you need someone to stay with the baby. Because he didn't put you out. Then where you going?
Back to him, like, please, baby. That's how it be. They go, I do whatever I need to do to get back in the house. And that's when things get weird. But yeah, definitely. I know what definitely when I heard this, dog. Definitely a story. What the shit? Like,
right?
What is the shit? Like, I can't believe. But yes, I can. I can't believe this. We ain't heard of crazier things, but this story really kind of stuck out to me. So, you know, hopefully we can have more talks like this. You know, like I said, we don't see each other all the time like I like us to see. but when we do, I do like how we sit here, catch up, talk about what's going on.
Right.
You know, you send me stuff, I send you stuff, but. We're gonna go on, cut it short. We're gonna end it. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Make sure y'all hit that subscribe button. I hope y'all.
Thank you for listening. We really enjoy doing this. You can like, comment, subscribe, share, do whatever you feel like you want to do. But thank you for tuning in, and we will see y'all at another time.
All right, y'all be safe out there. Make sure you have your mask.
And stay out of Florida.
Stay away from little kids. Please stay away from little kids.
Let them live their life.
Right.
Give them a chance.
Do not corrupt them.
All right. Bye, YouTube.
All right. See you guys later. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button.
So for everybody stating their opinions about me and my husband, I can't go on my shit because some ignorant ass hoes got me fucking blocked for 30 days. So I'm in Facebook jail right now. But since y'all want to go on his page, we just gonna settle this shit now. I'm gonna say this and I'm gonna be done with this shit and let y'all little ignorant ass, no class ass hoes talk after this shit. Me and my husband, we're married. Me and my husband ain't going nowhere. I don't give a fuck. I don't care. I don't give two fucks at that, not even one, about y'all opinions. Y'all on here talking about, oh, I'm just stating my opinion. It don't mean shit to us. So why the fuck waste your time and energy and your motherfucking time out of the day and your life to sit up here and keep on saying it? That's your opinion. We don't care. At the end of the day, everything is done. We're legally motherfucking married. I'm 18. I'm grown now. Talking about, oh, you just a baby. I'm 18, bitches. I moved out my mama's house when I was 16. 16. 16. Fucking 16. What did I do? Get a job. Get a job. Pregnant and all, working. Pregnant. Fucking working at 16 with no motherfucking body. I ain't had nobody. My mama was a druggie. Nobody. Never had nobody. I'm not saying this to show to have no sympathy or looking for sympathy. Nobody sympathizing with me. This is not what it's for. I'm just letting y'all know that I don't give a fuck about y'all opinions. It don't mean shit to me. It don't, because at the end of the day, everybody have a life to live. Okay, so what? He's 46, not 50. Thank you. He's 46. Half of y'all motherfucking mammies, he probably fucked half of y'all motherfucking peoples. Probably fucked your mammies. And you got y'all daddies mad, and some of y'all motherfuckers mad at him because he on his shit, and we both on our shit. And the fuck, y'all just mad because I'm happy. Deja always gonna be happy. No, y'all hoes thought that I wasn't never gonna be shit because of my past. That's what the fuck y'all thought, and I proved y'all wrong. That's why y'all hoes really mad. But at the end of the day, that shit ain't even worth it, because at the end of the day, I'ma do me. We gonna do us. I'ma continue wear this motherfucking rock on my finger, and I don't give a fuck what a bitch gotta say. I don't. I don't. Because at the end of the day, I'ma live my life. I'm going to live my life to the fullest. We only have one life, and that's what y'all fail to realize. Wake the fuck up. How about that? Wake the fuck up. And I don't give a fuck about all that laughing ass shit, because at the end of the day, y'all retarded. Y'all ignorant in the mind. Y'all ignorant for y'all to say, oh, you young and this and that. Okay, yeah, I'm young. So why would I want to be, just because I'm young, why would I want to be with a, if I got, my mind is more mature than being with a motherfucking young ass nigga. Why would I want to be with a young ass nigga and motherfucking, he want to lay and play. He don't know shit. Like you said, like y'all said, how I'm young and my mind ain't open all the way. Okay, well, a young nigga is even worse than a young female. Why the fuck would you think that I want to sit around and be with a young nigga that want to fuck other people and want to, and don't got his mind made up, don't know what he want, don't want to commit, don't want to get out his mama house, don't want to do that? Why the fuck would I want that? That's not what I want. I don't want that. I want to be with a nigga that know what the fuck he want in life. I want to be with a nigga that got his stacked up his bread. I want a nigga like that. I don't want no nigga that want to go be with this. And half of them niggas y'all fucking with is motherfucking faggots. They fucking faggots. And I know faggots. I got friends that's faggots that motherfucking tell me about y'all niggas getting fucked. About y'all niggas getting fucked. Come on, dad. Come on. Be for real. Wake the fuck up, you sad ass hoes. Y'all talking about me? I know. Half of y'all motherfucking hoes get mad because y'all niggas undercover faggots. That's all that is. That's all that is. But at the end of the day, a bitch can't go around saying, my nigga no faggot. My nigga don't play that. My nigga don't play that.
Look at my stats, bitch.
For real. Nigga got plenty bread. My nigga, we can own the whole motherfucking, we can own half of the shit around this bitch. We can own half of that. We ain't got time for that shit. We don't. I don't even fuck with nobody. For y'all to come out, okay, y'all always claim, oh girl, you fucked that in. At least I got the balls to say I am, bitch. At least I got the balls to say I am. Yeah, fuck. Yeah, I don't fuck people. And I got the balls, bitch. That's all that matter. I got the balls. I can say that. And you know why I can say that? Because I changed. I changed, bitch. How about you do?
I don't know. But that hoe got me fucked up. Because I ain't it. Find something safe to do. So, this was it is, right? I'm on live. So, my daughter and Mike Huckabuck married each other, right? I don't approve of that stupid ass cartoon ass shit. And that's what the fuck I said. I ain't even go to that fuck ass shit. Mike, you know I fucked your ass in 2017 in my apartment in the motherfucking LP. When you was coming over there hard. Anybody who know me know that I stayed over y'all seen that fat stank ass nigga the fuck over there. Okay? For a cell phone, $150. Okay? I was working at Family Dollar, and I need some extra money. So that's what that was about. I told this dumb, and then when she ran away when I stayed over there with my oldest daughter in Jacksonville, Mike was the main one talking about this is my goddaughter. Y'all help me find her. Da-da-da-da. Y'all remember that shit? Y'all remember when I whooped Deja ass in that kitchen too? Like the 14-year-old little girl she was. Yeah, y'all remember that shit? So, with that being said, Deja's my last child. Her name really is Deja Miaya Evans. Like Davinia Evans, mine. She just got adopted in 2016, right before I came home. Okay, by Ashley Jackson, white chick. Alright, so, with that being said, Deja doesn't remember when she was little. She don't remember when she was with me. I lost my kids through DCF. Love y'all, know you snout patty, sold a lot of motherfucking drugs. Whooped a lot of ass, went to jail a lot. I was young and wild as fuck. I done apologize, and I'd be goddamn if I apologize in a motherfucking mode. But bitch, you said you married Mike because you need stability. Okay, so, your son, your stepson, my little cousin, your little cousin. Yeah, he didn't know whether to call you his godmama or his motherfucking god. I mean, his stepmama or his god sister. I say, is she your god sister or your stepmama or your cousin? He said, she my god sister and my cousin. No, my stepmama and my cousin. No, he said, my stepmama and my god sister. That's sad. So, all this shit, what Deja putting up, all this shit with Mike and all that, let me tell y'all motherfuckers something. Because first of all, I'm a real motherfucking witch, bitch. Because if I want to get you, I'll get you. Please don't sleep, okay? I ain't got to come and do nothing physical to you. I promise I will send the spirits to you, bitch. Now fuck with me. You, your husband, the family, I don't give a fuck. Bitch, I'm over here. You was just over here to this house yesterday talking about how much you love me, playing with me and jumping on me. But then all of a sudden you on motherfucking Facebook talking about, oh, I'm at my grandma's house. Bitch, take your ass over there. You need to be motherfucking black matized, hoe. Stay your fucking ass over there with the white people in the west side. Bitch, I'm east side. Fuck wrong with you. I born in Cape Charles, Virginia on the Eastern Shore, raised in goddamn Gifford. That sound like Eastern fuck to me. So, with all that being said, fuck all that shit. Fuck all that. I love my granddaughter, Noonie. I sure do. But before I kiss anybody ass to spend any time with her, I'm done. I got one grandson. His name is Giovanni Josiah Robinson. He a little red bone, little cute little thing with dreads and be with his nanny all the time. My knee baby, that's my bestie. And I love her to death. Yes, yes, she is my favorite child. And you know why? Because she say, yes, ma'am, please, may I know and thank you. And she respects the fuck out of me. Even through my fucking past addiction. Bitch, I ain't snort powder, smoked cigarettes since 2000. 6-24-15. That's my clean date. How about that? Top that. And I ain't have to go to no motherfucking program to do that shit. I ain't have to go to jail, prison, none of that. I just got tired of losing. So I changed my life. So before I let any motherfucking body talk about, oh, peaches dead, peaches dead, and I ain't got AIDS. This pussy real clean. All my kids came to Sarah and it's tight as fuck. That's why y'all niggas stay in my shit. Let me tell you something. That's why her fucking my daughter's husband was deep begging me for my pussy for years. And when I finally let him get some of it, he tried to play me, so we fell out. That's why when he put her ass out right 3 weeks before they got married, she came in the house. I had a bathing suit and went to the truck, talked to the man in the back seat. Mike gonna tell me, you just want somebody to see that fat pussy. Don't you go with my daughter? Didn't you just bring her over here to get some more of her stuff that you brought over here? That me and my knee baby helped bring in this motherfucking house in the gardens? But did you just say that to me? See, I be quiet about a lot of shit because I don't be snapping. I don't be having time. But I got, bitch, I got high blood pressure. I got high blood pressure, and that shit came from hypertension because I go from 0 to 1,000,005 real fucking fast. I am Puerto Rican. I am Geechee mostly. I am Navajo. I am Bahamian. And I got a little Irish. So that means, yes, I am crazy. So stay in your motherfucking lane and leave me the fuck alone. Leave me alone, because I ain't it. Leave me alone. Deja, whatever the fuck, Leilani, Lonnie, whatever the fuck, Young Jackson, Huckabuck, whoever the fuck you are, stay out my motherfucking face, hoe. Please, don't ever speak to me again in life, and I mean that. I mean that. You were literally just fucking over here yesterday, hugging and kissing on me. Now you on Facebook yesterday talking shit. Man, look, girl, I mean today, talking cash shit. Don't do that. Don't do that. Find something safe to do, little girl. You 18. I'm not Killer B and all them little hoes you be arguing with. Come Mike study fucking bitches and bringing diseases. When your ass was over here, your pussy was itching then. I had to bleach my shit out. Cause your motherfucking itching pussy motherfucking ass over here. Laying all in. You had to sleep with me, hoe. And then 3 weeks later, you go get married. You dumb ass bitch. It ain't my fault that you dumb as fuck. I'm sorry. I might have did start a little too much battle with your ass. Okay? That's probably what happened. The fuck? Let me tell